So here with Nicola Caines, the editor of the Brighton Hove Independent newspaper, out weekly on a Thursday and Friday. It's the new edition's out, isn't it? At over 200 stores, Nicola. So we're going to talk about this week's edition, Race for Life. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, so I think we said last week we had the brilliant marathon back, didn't we? So that was great to see that back in the city. We covered that well, lots of pictures online. There was that bit of a hiccup, wasn't there? One of the cones was misplaced and the marathon ended up being slightly too long. Yeah. But I think overall people kind of just took it in their stride, to use a pun. And it was still a fantastic event. The marathon raised lots and lots of money for charities. And I went along to watch a bit of it as it came through Hove. So that was fantastic. And then, yeah, straight on the back of that, this weekend we've had the Race for Life. Really good to see that back as well. Stanmer Park. And Brighton's event was like a bumper day. So it had obviously the usual 5K kind of little race. And then they added onto it a 10K and a 3K. And then they also had a children's muddy run, which looked very, very messy. And then they did an adult version of that as well. And yeah, we've got some lovely pictures from the organisers, Cancer Research UK. We've had them on our website, but we've also picked a nice selection of those for the newspaper this week. And yes, apparently they've raised about £86,000 for Cancer Research UK, which obviously a lot of charities have struggled a bit during the lockdown and fundraising events haven't been able to take place. So that's been a really good boost for cancer research. Yeah. And yeah, hopefully lots of people had fun on the day. And yeah, if anyone's got any other pictures of themselves having fun, then we're always kind of grateful for people sending their pictures in to us as well. But yeah, yeah, so
It was fun. And as you say, my brother ran it. And so I was out and about. And he ran it. It was about half a mile too far. So his personal best got put down 3 or 4 minutes, I think, on the back of that. So it was 4 hours 3 instead of 4 hours 7 or 8.
Which was the marathon, was it?
Yeah, that's a marathon, yeah. And I know there was a Race for Life as well, as you were just talking about. I know you've got a campaign starting up about gas prices. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, so obviously it's been in the national news a lot, hasn't it? Lots of the energy companies, there's going to be this new price cap because the rise in gas prices. So the companies will put the prices up, unfortunately, for residents. A lot of the gas companies might actually cease to exist. There's obviously it's a bit worrying, but we're trying to kind of give readers advice and kind of point them in the right direction of what they should be doing and thinking about kind of switching energy suppliers and that, or getting like a fixed term tariff. But at the same time, speaking to kind of local charities, because there are obviously worries. Lots of people already had to turn to food banks, didn't they, in lockdown. And I know all of our Brighton and Hove amazing kind of food banks and charities have done an amazing job. They were so busy. And unfortunately, the energy price hike may then have a knock-on effect that people will be turning to those again. So we want to highlight it, but in a way that we're going to be telling people where to go if they do need to turn to a food bank, give them some advice on what they can do. It is worrying, obviously, for people, but there are things you can put in place now to try and kind of get a fixed term tariff or switch your energy supplier. So, yeah, we'll have lots of kind of advice and local kind of reaction to that as we launch this campaign this week.